have a glossary entitled "Don't Drink the Lemonade, There's Something Funny in It." You'll understand what that means in a little bit. So, first thing you guys need to know is how to turn this on. So the first thing you'll need to know is which cooperative learning tent you will have. So group one, Annalise, Taylor, David, Kristen, know your role, okay? Tyler, Sarah, Monique, and Jennifer. Materials managers, at the end of the lesson, when all of this is over, before our last section, you're gonna clean up when you're told to. So just remember who you are because you're gonna be responsible for cleanup. First thing that we're gonna do is go through and explore. So I want you guys to take one and pass it down. So before you fill out your observations, we're gonna learn how to make observations for this exploration. Let me know, look at me when you're all done, when you all have your guide. Does anyone else have a guide? Raise your hand if you do not have a guide. Okay. So, go ahead and pick up your guide, move over to your station. Sorry. And when you get there, you need to put your safety goggles on. If you do not remove them, until you are able to do so. We're not actually going to burn it, we're just going to bring the flame close to it. We don't want it to catch on fire, but we have our water here in case it does catch on fire. What do you notice that's different about the paper now? Tyler?
It now has a kind of black and yellow tinge to it.
Do you think that the paper has changed at all? The substance has changed?
Look, it's a permanent color change, yeah.
How would you know? Do you think you can reverse this? You can make it be what, come white again?
No. Yeah, can you wipe it off?
Would you like to try?
Yeah.
See, you can wipe this off. Is the paper white again?
No.
No. Okay, so would you say that you can turn it back to white
No.
by rubbing it off? All right, so keep in mind that you'll be referring to these answers later on. So the kind of observations you were making, things having to do with color, whether you think the substance is the same or not, those are the things that you're going to be discussing in your groups as we proceed throughout the investigation. So, first thing we're going to talk about is safety. Before you get started, you always have to go over safety. So do not remove your goggles until instructed to do so by the teacher. You are already told to put your goggles on, so everyone who does not have their goggles on You owe me one coupon at the end of this lesson. Next thing, if you're looking at your tray, you're gonna notice that there's some lemonade, there's some sugar, some milk, all things that may seem really yummy to you, you don't eat or drink materials in the classroom, especially not in the science classroom. The next thing is to use caution when transferring liquid materials. Your nothing here is gonna burn you, but we still don't wanna make a mess. And then if anything spills, immediately report it to your maintenance director. And you guys all have paper towels, so if there's any spills, you can clean them up. Nothing's gonna be too dangerous, but it's better to work with a clean station. So you guys have already moved to your new station, and the time portion is gonna begin once I finish going over these questions with you. Okay, so you're gonna take a plastic cup in front of you and pour the cup, a little ice water into the plastic cup. Then you're gonna go through these questions and you're gonna have a minute and 30 seconds to do so. Okay, I'm gonna be walking around making sure that you're actually discussing these questions. If you have any concerns or any questions, just let me know while I'm walking around. And your minute 30 seconds is going to start now. What are you supposed to do? Now pour the water out of that cup and back into the cup labeled ice water. Then wipe out the bottom of your plastic cup and let it sit to the side. Writing your observations, go ahead and do that. Time is up. We'll move on to the next setup in our investigation. So now we're going to be dealing with the milk and the lemon juice that's in front of you. What you're going to do is you're going to put the cup of milk and lemon juice in front of you, pour the lemon juice into the cup of milk, and use popsicle stick to stir for 5 seconds. Your popsicle sticks are labeled stirrer. Then you're going to place the lemonade and sugar in front of you, pour the sugar into the lemonade, use the popsicle stick to stir that for 30 seconds. You use two different popsicle sticks. Okay? You're going to have 2 minutes to do this and then answer the question, what happened when the sugar was mixed with the lemonade? Did you notice another substance appear in the cup? 2 minutes is going to start. What would you write about that? What do you guys think that is?
Sugar.
What's the next step? What do you do with sugar?
They're asking me what I think.
No, what's this here in the cup with the milk? You guys have about a minute left.
Yeah.
remember to answer question 5A, what happened when the sugar was mixed with the lemonade? Did you notice another substance appear in the cup? Think about what that means when you ask another about another substance appearing in the cup. Is that milk? Is that lemon juice? And is it the lemonade? No, not yet.
Oh, that's interesting.
That's what we don't answer.
We didn't mean
anything about the milk.
Okay, we're just answering number 5 right now. But we're giving everything else time. So number 5 was about lemonade and sugar. So time for that is up. You are going to have a minute to complete the next portion. So this is going to be more answering questions about the plastic cup and about the milk and lemon juice. So questions 6 and 7, part A and B. You'll have a minute to answer the questions. Did the color change remain after letting the plastic cup sit? Do you think the substance of the cup has changed? For number 7, we're going to be looking at milk and lemon juice. What happened when the lemon juice was mixed with the milk? Do you think that there was a new substance in that cup? All right, so you're going to have a minute to complete that. Your minute is going to start right now. Time is up for your explore. You're going to stay here for the explain, but I'm going to hand it over.
All right. So time is up. Did y'all get everything? Finished all the answers? Take a couple seconds. More time? Okay. Take a little more time. Our group is finished. Put your pencils down when y'all are ready. Alright. Looks like one person's finishing up, and we'll go ahead and get started. So, on the these out. So y'all are about to get the explanation guide. Go ahead and pass these down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't get ahead of yourselves and start answering.
Yeah.
Just give it just a second. If there's any extras, hand them out to the end. So, right now there's a couple of questions on here. What I want y'all to do is, whenever we're going over these, we're going to refer to your exploration guide in order to answer these. So we're going to take a little bit with your group to answer each question, and then we're going to kind of go over them as a class. Sound good? Yes? Thumbs up? Yeah? Awesome.
Yeah.
Good. All right, so first question I want y'all to look at. What is different about what you see in the bottom of the lemonade versus what it's in the milk? Take about 20 seconds, discuss with your group.
Mm-hmm.
distributed throughout.
We know that there was no white chunky substance.
There's definitely separation at the bottom.
But we know that there were sugars.
There's two different things.
Okay, you said the tip.
Okay, awesome, guys. So up here, while y'all are finishing these out, take some time to write, but as we're doing this, I'm gonna ask somebody to tell me what y'all thought, so. Taylor, what was the difference?
Well, in the lemonade, the sugar just sat on top of it, but in the milk, there's this white foamy substance that's mixed throughout the milk.
Okay. Anybody disagree, agree? Anybody have anything to add to that? No? All right, good job. So difference, like you said, sugar versus, one of them was sugar. She said there was still kind of sugar on top. And the other one was this white foamy new substance, correct? All right, so next question is, what does the difference between the leftovers say about the type of change occurring? Take a few seconds, talk amongst your peers. So, Jennifer,
yes.
What did y'all discuss?
He said that the difference was a chemical versus a physical change. So the physical change was the lemonade and the sugar, and the chemical change was the lemonade
and the sugar. Okay, and how did y'all get to that?
Because the physical change, you can separate the lemonade from the sugar, and then the milk, the chunky stuff is new.
Awesome, good job. Awesome. No, good job. So, new substance was formed in one of them, and this new substance is evidence of a chemical change, just like y'all said. Alright. So, next question. What was different? Do y'all need to write any of that down? No? Okay. So, what was different about the color change in the cups and the color change in the paper?
Do you still have the paper? Did it go back to you?
Yeah, we haven't seen it.
The paper?
Mm-hmm.
The ripped paper is right there.
Do y'all want me to leave this over here? Do y'all want me to pass it around? Do y'all look? Right. So, as y'all are passing that around, taking a look, Monique, what did y'all discuss?
We said that the cup went back to its original color, and the paper stayed brown in that one spot where it was touched by the flame.
Did y'all in this group, the first group, notice anything different that she did? No? Perfect. All right, so the cup returns to its original color, and the paper color change was the same. So what does this mean about the type of change that occurred?
The cup was
different. The paper was cut. Annalise, what did your group discuss? Exactly right. So the substance of the burned paper is different than the original and can't be, because what you noticed is it can't go back, right? We all saw that the paper is still that color, and whereas the substance of the cups, it went back, so it's the same substance. All right, so we're going to take a minute. We're going to watch this video, watch the following video. Ooh. take a minute, look at the banana. The banana's doing some funky things.
Sorry, that's
okay. All of y'all have seen this happen with the banana in real life, correct?
Yes.
Y'all all noticed this. Do y'all usually, whenever y'all, the banana starts to look like this, do y'all eat it still? What do y'all do with the banana?
Damn it.
I think it's gonna
do. Once it gets that bad.
Yeah, we don't get them.
Alright. So.
The funky banana.
So, what was happening to the banana? Use the concepts that we have covered. Oh, we're going to do this. Okay, yeah. So, after watching this video, what was happening to the banana? And using the concepts we covered, how would you describe or define this reaction? What evidence backs up your answer? Awesome. David, you said some really good things. I want to hear what you had to say about this.
First, I wanted some more information because I don't know what happened in it after the video.
Okay.
But then, my colleagues pointed out that it did kind of change form too, so water evaporated from the stem of the banana, indicating that it underwent a chemical change as well, not just the color change.
Okay.
So we think that it did undergo a chemical change.
Awesome. Do y'all have anything to add to that, take away from that, group two?
Once it changes, it won't go back.
Perfect. So, was there any new matter produced in this?
Probably, yeah.
You can't really tell from the, well, looking at the video, you saw a color change, right? With that color change, did the matter, was there any new matter forming on top of that? Was that brown color a different thing? Or was that just color change? It was the same stuff changing.
No,
you can't really tell from the video.
Okay.
So.
It's still a banana.
Yes, it's still a banana.
But it just changed colors.
Yes. So what I'm trying to get to here is we don't want to misconceive that there's new matter forming when you do all this. So we're about to go over a couple of things, but whenever this all happens, y'all aren't seeing new matter, right? Y'all are seeing matter change, correct?
Yes.
Yes. Good. We all agree? Awesome. Really fast, though, I want to go over what two things have we really hit on here, as we're talking about chemical change. Cool? So what two things have we really hit on here that are evidence of chemical change? What have y'all noticed between y'all's experiments?
Do you want us to answer you or talk to our groups?
Answer. Talk to your groups for a second, and then I got
color
you.
Change,
especially
liquids and fluids. All right, Sarah. Sorry, it's right here. What did your group notice?
We noticed that one had a color change.
Good. Color change. So, talking about chemical change. Sorry, I don't mean to stop you.
That's okay.
Color change. So, evidence of a chemical change can be color change. How would color change be that evidence, though? In what ways? Because we saw two different color changes.
Because if it's a chemical color change, it can't go back to
it. It can't go back.
Yeah, so irreversible.
Irreversible would be another word for irreversible.
Permanent.
Good job. So, permanent color change, or cambio de color, color, thank you, can be evidence of chemical change. Now, as you all have already seen, color change doesn't necessarily mean that it's a chemical change, just that permanent can be evidence. Okay, what was one other one, I heard it. Taylor, what was the other thing mostly focused on?
That a new substance was produced.
A a new substance was produced. Perfect. Does anybody know what that new substance might be called? How would we term that?
Precipitate.
Precipitate. Thank you. So, precipitate, whoops, or precipitato is what happens when you mix two things and the solid, as y'all saw, what y'all noticed in the milk, there was a solid substance formed. That precipitate is evidence of a chemical change because that's obviously something new, correct? Did y'all have a solid when you poured in the milk and the lemonade? No, those were two liquids, right? And it created the solid. What other ways can we see a precipitate in real life? What else do you think? Kristen. What other precipitates could you see in real life? What's an example?
Rust.
Good job. Is rust something that's obviously, so rust, what would you say rust? When you look at rust, what's forming rust?
Iron and oxygen.
Iron and oxygen. Two things forming something totally different, right? So precipitate, precipitato, new substance forming can be evidence of a chemical. Oh, sorry. All right, so one more question, as we already talked about. Kool-Aid, how many of y'all drink Kool-Aid? Everybody's drinking Kool-Aid, right? I love Kool-Aid. My favorite's blue, but we got some red here. When you mix Kool-Aid, what kind of changes this? What do you notice? What do you notice when you mix Kool-Aid? What happens to the water? Jennifer?
It mixes with the water to create a new mixture.
Does it change colors?
Yes, it changes.
Yes. Is that color easy to get back? Annalise.
No, because if you spill it on your clothes, it won't come back.
Okay. So, as we've already talked about, what does that make y'all think it is? What kind of change? Monique. It would be, but not necessarily. So, sometimes something might seem permanent, right? But that doesn't mean that it's not. Does anybody know how you might be able to change the color back? It's going to be very difficult, but does anybody have any idea how you might do that?
If you evaporate it, you'd be left with the Kool-Aid because the water would evaporate out.
Exactly. So you could get back to the water, correct? So therefore, what kind of change would this be? Tyler.
Physical.
Good job. So y'all see how just because something might seem like it's something that can't go back, that doesn't necessarily mean that it's not permanent? Perfect. All right, so wrapping up, there's a couple of questions that I want y'all to answer. A color change indicates a chemical change if the color change is what, Sarah?
Permanent.
Perfect, permanent. Make sure y'all film these out as y'all go, sorry. When we mix the lemon and juice in the milk, the chunky substance that was produced is called the? David.
Precipitate.
Good job. Precipitate. And true or false, when a new substance is produced from a chemical change, new matter is formed. What did you answer, Tyler?
True.
Ooh, why do you say true?
Because I misread the question.
So, when a new substance is produced from a chemical change, new matter is formed. True or false? You said true originally, you said you misread it, you changed your mind. What made you think true?
Well, something new is being formed.
Is it new, something new is being formed, but does that mean new matter is being formed, or that it's two things becoming something different?
Two things becoming something different.
There you go. So, when a new substance is produced from a chemical change, new matter is formed, true or false?
Type false.
There you go. Good job. Does that make sense to everybody? So, just because there's a new thing doesn't mean it's new matter. Perfect. So, we're going to go ahead and give you all a little evaluate. I'm going to pass them out. Answer these on your own and hand these back in. Write your name. Don't forget. And after you answer them, just so you know, the first group of questions, the first four, are short answer. You're going to fill in whether they are a physical or chemical change. And the second